क्रूसिदरे
During the 50 days Lent, today, the 47th day, I'm going to speak about the Last Supper of Jesus Christ. Last Supper, also called Lord's Supper in the New Testament, the final meal shared by Jesus and his disciples in an upper room in Jerusalem, the occasion of the institution of the Eucharist, the story of the Last Supper on the night before Christ's crucifixion is reported in four books of New Testament, Matthew chapter 26, Mark chapter 14, Luke chapter 22 and 1 Corinthians chapter 11. The story of the Last Supper is about the wonderful invitation from Jesus to receive his gift. The Last Supper took place on the first day of Passover, or Festival of Unleavened Bread. Jesus sent his disciples ahead into the city to prepare a meal to celebrate Passover. Passover is the remembrance of Israel being freed from slavery to Egypt, and specifically when the angel of death passed over the homes of Israelites that had lamb's blood over the doors. As the disciples reclined and ate dinner with Jesus, he explained to them that one of the 12 of them would soon betray him. One by one, the disciples denied that it would be them, including Judas, who would be the betrayer. Jesus responded that the person who betrays him will have a terrible fate, and that indeed it was Judas. Jesus prayed and thanked God for the meal. He then broke the bread and shared the wine with the disciples and explained to them how the bread was a symbol of his body broken for them, and the wine a symbol of his blood which would be poured out for the sins to be forgiven. This is where the church tradition of communion comes from. After the meal, Jesus became like a servant and washed the feet of the disciples. Peter did not feel right having Jesus wash his feet, but Jesus said that he was doing it to be an example to them. Now, the disciples would be able to wash each other's feet, meaning they could be servant to all. The symbolism of communion in the Last Supper. The Lord's Supper is also a time to be in communion. We are connected not only with Lord who saved us, but also with past and present believers. Among members of God's family, we find comfort and support just as disciples and early church did. Today, as you ponder Jesus' Last Supper, seek to make this event real for you. This was a night to remember. Jesus made this clear when he broke bread, gave thanks and told the disciples, "This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Luke chapter 19 verses 22. So today the celebration of the Lord's Supper looks back to crucifixion, where Christ's blood was shed for sinners, but also forward to the marriage supper of the Lamb. So today, the celebration of Lord's Supper looks back to the crucifixion, where Christ's blood was shed for sinners, but also forward to the marriage supper of the Lamb, where the redeemed will join their Lord in glory. Revelation chapter 19, 6 verses 10. It's a celebration indeed.